नमस्ते, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। दिस इज जेवी डॉक्टर राकेश शर्मा, प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑर्गन ऑफ मेडिसिन होम्योपैथिक फिलोसॉफी, विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। और टुडे सेशन इज स्टोटोस फिलोसॉफी चैप्टर 10, इन डिस्पोजिशन एंड द सेकंड बेस्ट रेमेडी। दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर एंड वेरी यूजफुल फॉर द प्रैक्टिस पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू। So let's start. Not every case which presents itself to the physician requires medicine. It may only require the searching out and correcting of some evil habit, some error in the mode of living, such as faulty diet, unsanitary surroundings, non-observance of ordinary hygienic requirements in regard to breathing, exercise, sleeping, etc. So हर केस के अंदर हमें मेडिसिन की ज़रूरत नहीं पड़ती है, हमें और दूसरे कॉजेज पे देखना चाहिए, उसकी बैड हैबिट्स के बारे में, मोड ऑफ लिविंग के बारे में, उसके फूड के बारे में। तो वहाँ से हमें कुछ उसके डिजीज़ का कुछ कॉजेज हमें पता लग सकता है। इन पैराग्राफ 4 पहली में सेज, द फिजिशियन इज लाइक वाइज ए प्रिजर्वर ऑफ हेल्थ इफ ही नोज द थिंग्स दैट डिरेंज health and cause disease and how to remove them from persons in health. So Dr. Hemingway clearly mentioned here, if physician knows those things that deranges the health, then it is his duty to remove from the person's life. In paragraph 5 also, the physician is enjoined to search out the most probable exciting cause of the acute disease, as also the most significant points in the whole history of the chronic disease, to enable him to discover its fundamental cause, which is generally due to a chronic illness. अब यह बात कर रहे हैं कि fundamental causes के बारे में, कि especially जब physician deal करता है chronic disease के साथ में, तो fundamental cause के बारे में खोजना, उनको find out करना जरूरी होगा। In making these investigation, he directs our attention to the physical constitution. अब इसके साथ में fundamental causes के साथ साथ में हमें physician को कौन उसका constitution कैसा है, his moral and intellectual character कैसा है उसका, his occupation, mode of living and habits कैसी है उसकी, his social and domestic relations कैसे हैं, his age and sexual function etc. But this line of investigation is equally fruitful and necessary in dealing with the indisposition of which I am particularly speaking. अब यहाँ पे ये नई चीज़ है कि indisposition के बारे में डॉक्टर हेमिंग्वे ने क्या कहा है, हमें इनको वहाँ कैसे डील करना है, पर के पॉइजन के अंदर में और फोर्थ में कि ऐसे कौन से पॉजिटिव को रिमूव कर सकते हैं और फंडामेंटल पॉजिटिव। इन द Note of paragraph 7, Hinman says, as a matter of course, every sensible physician will remove such causes at first. कौन से causes जो उसकी health को derange कर रहे हैं? After which the indisposition will generally cease spontaneously. तो उसका indisposition वो अपने आप ही खत्म हो जाएगा। By way of illustration, he goes on to say, he will remove from the room strong smelling flowers which have a tendency to cause syncope and hysterical sufferings, extract from the cornea the foreign body that excites inflammation of the eye, loosen the over-tight bandage on a wounded limb, ligature the wounded artery, promote the expulsion of poisonous ingesta by vomiting, extract foreign substances from the orifices of the body, crush or remove vesical calculi, open the imperforate anus of the newborn infant. In short, Hinman has done his best to make it clear that the use of common sense is not conflicting with homeopathic practice. His enemies and some of his over jealous followers to the country in spite of. Consider for a few moments then that class of cases which require for their use only the correction of faulty habits and the removal of exciting causes. Consider also that it often requires the exhibition of as much wisdom, skill, good judgment and tact to perform this function as it does to prescribe medicine. Indeed, it often requires more. It is much easier to give out medicine and release the patient than it is to make a careful investigation of the habits and circumstances of a patient who probably does not need medicine at all, but only wise and kindly advice on how to live. Great is the power and value of homeopathic medicine, but like all other good things, it can be abused. Even high potencies can be abused and cause harm, as I saw illustrated very strikingly when I was sent for in haste to see a patient for whom I had prescribed a few days before. An experience of that kind has a strong tendency to remove any doubt one may have as to power of high potencies. It also conveys an impressive warning against too frequent repetition of doses. Moreover, it upsets the theory that high potencies do not act upon the yeast. Returning to the subject of indisposition, having discovered such a case and that determined that it does not require medication, the question arises, how is such a case to be managed? At first sight, it would seem to be a very simple matter, merely to tell the patient abruptly, go to Kedena, that he does not need medicine, even medicine is available, but only to repair his life and correct his habits according to the advice and instruction which you have given or will give. This view of the matter does not take into consideration the peculiarities of human nature as formed by ages and generations of habit and custom. Only occasionally do we meet a patient to whom we can give ideal advice and treatment. In spite of the rapid growth of the no drug idea as communicated by the various modern folk, the average patient who goes to the doctor expected to get medicine, if he is so far advanced in his ideas as to believe in the no drug theory, he will probably not go to the doctor at all, but will seek out the stupid or the Christian Science healer. The patient who believes in drugs and goes to doctor for treatment will be very likely to listen doubtfully to your well-meant advice and will depart to tell his friends in anything but a respectful manner that he thought you were a doctor, but he found that you were only half-baked Christian scientist at doctor. मतलब कि जो पेशेंट है डॉक्टर के पास आता है तो डॉक्टर देखना चाहिए कि उसकी मेडिसिन की जरूरत है या नहीं है, या एक सिंपल इंडिस्पोजिशन है तो हम उसको डाइट से है, उसके लाइफ स्टाइल के अंदर जो गलत चल रहा है उससे हम उसको मैनेज कर सकते हैं, उसको बता सकते हैं। लेकिन कई बार क्वेश्चन ये होता है कि उसको सिर्फ मेडिसिन लेने ही आता है आपके पास में, उसको मेडिसिन ही चाहिए, उनको कन्विंस करना मुश्किल हो जाता है। तो उनको कैसे कन्विंस करना है वो हम नेक्स्ट पार्ट में पढ़ेंगे। लेकिन जहाँ पर पेशेंट की साइकोलॉजी ऐसी होती है तो उसको जो मेडिसिन चाहिए, तो समझदार होते हैं वो उस चीज़ को मान जाते हैं। और ये सब चीज़ें बहुत ही ज़्यादा काउंटेबल है कि हाउ यू कन्विंस और मैनेज योर पेशेंट ईदर द नीड ऑफ मेडिसिन और नॉट। Besides that, he often dislikes the statement that this trouble is due to his own ignorance or willfulness. और इसके अलावा he often वो आपकी advice को पसंद भी नहीं करता कि ये जो है दिक्कत मुझे मेरी गलती की वजह से हो रही है। There is a large class of people today, selfish, pleasure-seeking, luxury-loving male and female who demand of the physician relief from the pains and penalties of their hygienic sins, but are not willing to do their necessary part toward bringing this about. They want to eat their cake and have it too. मतलब उनको इस चीज़ का रियलाइजेशन नहीं है कि सारी गलतियाँ मेरी वजह से हैं, मैं इनका जिम्मेदार हूँ और इस चीज़ को मानने के लिए तैयार नहीं हूँ। अगर डॉक्टर को इस चीज़ का समझाता भी है तो वो इस चीज़ को बुरा कर देते हैं और बुरा मानते हैं। This session powered by digital version 2.0 Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. I hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention in comment box. I will resolve it. Thank you.